This is my wig. I know. You not think this looks like natural hair? This is literally the most realistic, bombest. Oh no, what happened to my chain? Anyway, the bestest ever. Most realistic looking wiggage that I've probably ever had. So I thought I would share this with you, share the deets. The hair that I got a 16, a, no, 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 let me start again. I got an 18 inch, a 16 inch, and a 14 inch weave. I got three bundles in each length. And then I also got a 16 inch closure. The closure's from a different seller to the bundles. The closure's from Bliss, Wigs, and the bundles are from Yvonne Hair. The reason why I got the bundles and the closure from two different vendors is because I did a lot of research, and Bliss Wigs do a closure that's a lot kinkier than the hair. So it really matches well with natural hair, as you can see. Whereas the bundles are slightly looser, less textured hair. So it's really good quality. I wouldn't have had it any other way, to be honest, because I think the two kind of complement each other quite well. Let's see if I can show you. I think my blending looks really good. Anyway, this is the closure. As you can see, it's kind of kinky. And this is the hair. These are the weave bundles. And it's just a bit looser. If you can see the difference side by side. Yeah, but anyway, this has given me a life because I wanted to give my hair a break from the everyday handling. So by having a wig, it gives me options. Sometimes just the manipulation on my hair, I think, is probably not a good thing. And I really am trying to grow my hair and retain as much length as possible. So this is the perfect protective style, because not only does it look like my natural hair, it also means that I don't have to do a lot to blend. So I literally flat twisted, I've got this much hair out, about 2 inches, I would say. I literally flat twist my hair with some moisturizer and oil and a little bit of leave-in conditioner, and I just took it out when I was ready to put my wig on, and that's it. I'm good to go. It literally takes no blending whatsoever. The maintenance of the hair is fantastic. I just spray it with water and conditioner in a spray bottle, shaken up, spray, spray, spray. I do that every night. When the curls are getting a bit frizzy and I need to try and define the curls again, what I tend to do is spray the hair, and I saturate it quite a lot. The hair is probably about 50% wet, but not the roots, just the ends. And then I use some Eco Styler gel just on the top layer where the Bliss closure is, the kinkier hair, just to help define and make the curls pop. And that is it. I do that probably once every evening or once every other day. And then by the morning, the hair's dry, nicely curled, and I just put it on my head. Like, that is it. So I'm really looking forward to seeing how much growth I have been able to retain when I take it out. But I'm gonna see if I can keep this going until about April, and I'm going on holiday in April, so I'll have my hair out again then. But I just love the option of having the wig, so I can switch back and forth between my hair without it being absolutely obvious or very obvious that I'm doing that. So yeah, it's been great. Anyway, the next part of the video, I'm going to show you how I constructed the wig and cut and style. So apologies in advance for the length of this video, but it was necessary in order for me to be able to show you everything. It's going to take about 20 minutes, so grab a cup of tea, put your feet up, and yeah, get ready. The link for the hair is below. If you need to know any other information about the hair, the styling, let me know. If you'd like me to do another video showing you the hairstyles or how I blend or anything like that, let me know. But I've put like the end-to-end process of how I made the wig and styled it in this video in an attempt to be as informative as possible without it being overly long. Enjoy, see you later. Oh, and welcome to everyone who hasn't watched my videos before. I always forget this. If you're new to my channel, please subscribe, like and comment the video and share it with your friends as well if you think anyone else would be interested in this hair. But yeah, looking forward to seeing what you think. Take care, bye.
I start off by bleaching the closure, and I use 20 volume bleach liquid and powder. I mix it in a bowl. I get the consistency to, it's a bit like Greek yogurt, like kind of thick. It makes peaks because I don't want it to seep through to the other side of the lace. So you place the lace closure upside down with the lace showing up, and you just pat really gently, like I said before, because you don't want the bleach to seep through, because what will happen is you'll end up with bleached hair on the other side that I just showed you. Then I turn it face down and leave it in some foil for about 15 minutes. I keep on checking it and rinse once it gets to the right colour, which is about a light blonde. To make the wig, I start off by using a mesh cap. You can get them from the hair shop. I also try to kind of thread two needles at a time so that I don't have to keep on stopping and starting throughout the sewing process, because it takes a long time. This part actually takes me around 3 hours. So I start sewing with the bottom weft. I kind of double up the stitches because that's the bit, I guess, that you're going to pull the most as you put on and take off the wig. When I get to the other side of the cap, I flip over the hair. So I don't cut the track, I just flip it over and start another row, which I sew backwards. So I'm left-handed, so I sew from left to right, get to the end, flip over the track, and then sew right to left. And I keep on doing that as I work through the wefts, sewing backwards and forwards, but I don't cut any of the wefts. The only weft that I cut is the weft that finishes the wig, also the weft that I sew around the closure once I get to the very top, which you'll see in a few minutes. When I sew, I do a stitch through the weft and I loop the hair under the thread to add some security. You can, and I sometimes do when I'm trying to save time, just like sew, like I'm sewing a button, just back and, like, you know, just up and over, up and over, up and over. But because I want this wig to last, I use a different method which adds more security. I know I'm not showing you a lot of the stitches, but you can see that I stitch a loop and then I thread through the loop in my hand. So I stitch through the cap, and then I thread through the loop before stitching again, just for the security that I mentioned. So I carry on doing this. Like I say, I have to keep on re-threading the needle. I started off by doing it on the stand, but to be honest, I was just doing it for you guys so you could get a better view. It's actually way more comfortable for me to just keep the mannequin head in my lap. Most of the time I actually use a polystyrene mannequin head, but this is the one that I use sometimes. I usually use it for colouring. It doesn't really matter, it's just a matter of preference, really. It doesn't really make a difference to how the sewing goes. But definitely I find that when I put the mannequin head in my lap, it's a lot easier to do because I don't have to stand up. And so obviously it's in my lap, I can control the mannequin head a lot easier when it's in my lap. So I just keep on sewing left to right, right to left, until I get towards the top. I'm about 2/3 of the way up, so now I put on the closure because I want to make sure that the tracks sew around the closure properly. So I use some pins, clothespins are fine, and I secure the whole way around the edge of the closure. I want it to be completely flush to the mesh cap so that when I sew, the closure doesn't start lifting up, and then I backstitch the whole closure down, working the whole way around from one side to another. So it's really important that you put the pins in and that the closure is completely flush to the cap, because otherwise what will happen is you'll get to the end, and because the closure wasn't taut to the or flush to the cap, there's like loose closure, and sometimes it can cause the closure to overhang beyond the cap, and you don't want that with a closure because it just won't look right. And you'll have to take off the whole closure and restitch it again. So make sure that the closure is flush to the mesh cap. You pin it down, use as many pins as you need to. When I have completely sewn down the closure, as you can see, I put a knot on the end because again, I don't want the closure to come loose. I then clip the hair out of the way and I just carry on sewing back and forth around the shape of the closure. So now that I know how the closure lies, I make sure that I leave space in between each track, but the shape, the curve of the track around the cap kind of mimics the closure at the shape of the closure, so that when I get to the top, it fits really neatly around the closure and there aren't any obvious gaps. Savages. So I'm really close to finishing now and I'm about to sew the last track. What I do with the last track is that I actually sew it around the edge of the closure. So not only do I sew the track to the cap, I actually put the stitches through the closure itself. This just adds a little bit extra security to the closure, making sure that the stitches don't come loose at a later date. Like I say, as you put on and take off a wig every single day or whenever you wear it, that's a lot of pull, so you want to invest the time now by making sure that everything's stitched down really securely. It will save you having to do repairs later on. Trust me, I've been there, it's long. Just do it now, do it properly. So what you can see me doing is the last weft is actually stitched onto the closure itself. And that's why as well, when you stitch the closure down, you want to make sure that stitch is really neat. Like I said, I back stitch just to add some security. And then when I'm stitching the weft through, I just stitch up and over each time. So I'm pretty much done. The hair is and the texture is a bit new to me, so I'm going to move on to the styling section, but I'm still looking at this wig at this moment thinking I don't know how this is going to look on my head, you know, but you know, I have done a lot of research, I have seen other people with this hair, so I'm pretty confident that it's going to look okay. But at first I'm like, oh, I don't know, because this curl looks a little bit looser than I was expecting. And I just can't see it quite yet. So what I start to do next is the styling part. For the styling part, I start off by spraying my wig with a mixture of water and conditioner. I put about 2 tablespoons worth of water. I'm brushing the hair through mainly because I want the two textures for the closure and the wefts, the tracks, to match or to blend a little bit better, because the closure is a lot more tightly curled than the hair wefts. So I'm just making sure that before I start trimming or anything like that, that I brush through the hair and I'm adding some water to make sure that the hair doesn't break as I do so, but also to try and kind of revive the curls and to recurl the hair. So as you can see, I'm using my Denman brush just to work through the knots, and I'm working from the bottom upwards. You know the drill, you never try and detangle hair top to bottom, because what you do is you pull out the hair and you don't want to be rough, because this hair is looped through the lace closure and then you'll start ripping out the hair. So be really careful whenever you're kind of brushing your weave weft, your closure weft. I actually don't start cutting or styling the hair until the next day. And as you can see, I've already braided my hair. I don't really care what my braids look like. To be honest, no one's seeing them. I put a stocking cap on my head and I'm going to cut the wig on my head to start off with, just to get the length right. I'll kind of interchange between cutting it on the mannequin head and cutting it on my own head, just because at different points I want to check how it looks on me and to get the shape right. But sometimes I'll put it on the mannequin head because it's easier to see, especially the back when it's not on your head. Cutting the back of your own hair is very hard. So I start cutting the sides you can see that I'm cutting in a diagonal kind of way, going down and inwards towards my neck, the reason why I do that is because I want the hair to have like a heart shape. I want it to be tapered. So I start off by placing small sections between my fingers and cutting in a diagonal way downwards and inwards. And I do that on each side based on the length that I want it and just the shape that I think will suit my face. And I just keep on retrimming each section and going back over any loose hairs. I've clipped up half at the top because you don't want to cut through your hair in big chunks. That's a bad idea. You want to take it in small sections. So it makes sense to start from the most bottom part of the hair and upwards. So I just carry on doing that diagonal cut downwards and inwards towards my face and my neck on each side, and then going back over it once I've released it from my fingers to just trim any curls that I have missed. And I just keep on doing that, but I'm not cutting a lot off at a time because I don't want to, you know, once you've cut it, it's too late. So you want to start by doing it in small sections and then having a look, see how it suits your face, and then cut again. And I just carry on doing that. The cutting process probably takes me a good 20 minutes, not because it takes a long time to cut, but because I'm taking my time to do it and go back over it again and again. So I've taken it off now because I want to check the back. Like I said, it's hard to check the back of your own hair as you're cutting it. So thank God for wigs and the ability to take them off. I just do exactly the same thing that I did whilst it was on my head and cut downwards and inwards. And then I just keep on spraying to, you know, recurl the curls. And I want to see how the texture lies. I want to see how kind of the length of the hair once it's curled. And as you know, when the hair's properly curled, it will lose a little bit of length because at the moment it's damp. And so I'm bearing that in mind whilst I'm cutting it, that it's probably going to shrink a little bit, much like my own natural hair would. And I have made that mistake before of cutting my hair when it's stretched, and then when it shrinks up, it's a problem. So just take your time on this. I go over everything that I've cut again because, like I say, it's easier to see how it looks when it's not on your head. And I'm just going by section, clipping down each section, making sure it matches the section below that I've just cut, and trimming in small parts until I'm happy, and just using my spray bottle until I'm done, really. I also use Frizzy's spray for curly hair. This is just something that I had sitting around the house. I don't think it's necessary. It does add a little bit of hold, but I don't think it's necessary. As you can see, my hair is looking pretty good, but there's still some long, straggly bits that I just want to trim. So I put it back on my hair, head again, and as I said, it's just easier to understand the shape and make sure it fits my face whilst it's on my head. So I just keep on going until I'm happy with it. And I, you know, I'm retwisting bits and just making sure the curls look right. You know, it's really important to do this bit. There's no point in spending ages sewing your hair and the style's not popping. To be honest, the style is the bit that everyone's going to notice. No one's really going to see the sewing bit that you do. It's only you that's going to know if your sewing wasn't up to par when your hair starts, when the tracks start coming loose. But the styling bit's really important. So take your time. See, I'm just taking out the perimeter of my hair just to see what it looks like when I try and blend it. And I'm starting to feel it, actually. I'm getting to the point where I'm like, yeah, okay. I can see this working. I'm feeling this. What I do on the closure is actually really kinky in comparison to the rest of the hair. So I add some Eco Styler gel and I just act as if I'm doing a wash and go. So I saturate the hair with the water and conditioner, and then I just coat some of the closure hair in gel. I found that this is really effective to make the curls more defined and to pop, and it just brings them back to life a little bit, especially after I've just used the Demon brush and brushed it all out. But the Demon brush plus the gel together are actually a really good combination. So I would say that the Eco Styler gel is a really good styling gel for the wig. And then I'm just scrunching the ends again just to kind of make the curls pop a little bit more and to define them, bring them back to life a little bit. And then once I finish doing that, I leave it to dry. It's the evening, so I've kind of done all my prep for the next day, and I leave it to dry. So I just go over each section using the water, conditioner. I'm using a bit of the Frizzies in that white bottle, but like I said, I think it's unnecessary. And just use the Eco Styler gel to define the curls and shingle For anyone that does wash and goes, you'll know what shingling is, but essentially it's taking where the hairs clump together and splitting out smaller sections so you've got those smaller individual curls. And to be honest, what you see me doing here with the spraying of the water, the detangling, and the gel is pretty much what I do anytime it looks like the curls just need to be revived a bit. I've had this wig now for about 3 weeks, so I'm used to how it behaves. And I can do this probably once every other night. I do this at night and I leave it to dry. And in the morning, it's just good to slap on my head and walk out of the door. So pretty much what you're seeing me do here is actually how I style the hair throughout. Whoops, you see, I missed a bit when I was cutting earlier. That's okay. I just keep on trimming. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video and you found it informative. I highly recommend this hair. I think it's a great hair texture to blend with your natural hair. So I'm a fan. I hope you try it and that you enjoy it too. And let me know what you think. Rate, comment, subscribe, please keep up with me. It'd be great for you to tell me what you think of my videos and become a subscriber. But thanks very much for watching and bearing with me. I know this is a really long video. But until the next time, take care, have a great day, whatever you do, and I will see you soon with the next video. Bye!